यस, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन स्टूडेंट्स। तो टुडे जस्ट विल डिस्कस द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी, दैट इज आवर नेक्स्ट यूनिट दैट इज गोइंग टू कम फॉर योर इंटरनल टेस्ट। ओके, जस्ट वेट अ मिनट। Yes, we'll try to understand the basics of probability. So just discuss how the concept of probability is there. I think this is the next unit what we are going to study. It is the fourth unit, and I would like to inform you that yes, this is what important unit we are going to discuss today. And you can see how the probability definition.
Sir, we have unit 3 for IA, right?
By mistake, it is been given as unit 3. Don't get confused. So we have discussed, the coordinators have discussed, and probability will be the fourth unit. So there is no confusion right now. Yes, students, any confusion? Unit 3 is not there, unit 4 it is actually. By mistake, it was been, means by mistake it is given like that. But don't get confused. Yes, so probability will be very easy as compared to unit 3. So it is easily understood, and if you know little bit English, definitely all the words will be very easy and it is quite understanding. So as you know probability, so I think you have already studied in the 10th also, am I right, student? So have you come across probability in the 10th?
Yes, sir.
So
yes, sir.
Yes, very good, thank you. So this is, yes, okay, so I have chosen this probability as the next topic, that is the fourth unit for your coming test. So here very simple discussion we are going to do, that is the experiment. So in the probability we come across experiment. So what is this experiment, students? It is a measurement process that produces qualifiable results. Like you do experiments in the lab, right? So these experiments we are going to have the measurement. So how the measurement, we take the process here as the experiment. So first, for example, we are going to say throwing two dice. Yes, you know already dice, you have been playing so many times, and you come across in the 10th also. So no, nothing to discuss about dice. You know already what is a dice. So when you throwing two dice, that is an experiment. Yes, dealing with cards. Yes, I think. Anybody, can you tell me how many in the card, can you tell me how many cards will be there in one pocket?
52.
Yes, very good. So it is 52. So this is an experiment. And a poker. Poker is a small experiment they used to play. So these are the simple examples. Not so this one, but you have to understand what is experiment. So measuring heights of people. Yes, recording proton-proton collisions. So some such type of experiments we come across in probability. Then you have to understand the word outcome. What is the outcome? Yes, so if you take a dais and you start rolling down, so every time one number is going to come. If it is not, what will be the outcome? It should not repeat. Means if I throw once, it will be one. I throw twice, if it comes one, the outcome we are going to take one only. If I throw thrice, it is going to come two. So like this, there are six outcomes in the dice. So what we say, these are the results. Yes, even in for your examination, we come across the results. Either you are going to pass and you become an engineer, yes, or you are going to fail, but still you are going to become an engineer. Nothing to worry. So next time you can appear and pass the exam. So however you are going to become engineer, but the outcome here is pass or fail in the examination. Yes. So what is the outcome? A single result from a measurement. Okay. So then we take simple example, the number of shown on the two dias. So if you take the two dias, if you roll down, it will be 1, 1. A second time if you go, then it will be 1, 2. So like this outcomes you are going to come, and you know already a simple word outcome, you are going to have the outcome in this probability. So you have to understand what is the word outcome. The next we have the sample space. So what is this space now? Yes, in general we see the space is so huge, yes, that we cannot calculate, that we cannot see throughout our environment, yes, but we say a sample space is the set of all possible outcome from an experiment. So here the sample space is a different one. We come across outcomes. So how many outcomes we are going to have, that many outcomes we are going to calculate, and we are going to count it, and that outcomes from an experiment is a set. Set, you know already, students, 1, 2 numbers are, number systems are sets, yes. Mechanical A division is a one set, mechanical B division is a one set, mechanical C division is a one set. So like this, we'll take the sample space as sets of all possible outcome from an experiment. So we say the set of all possible 5 cards hand. So if you take 5 possible cards of hand, you can say 5 different cards, set of cards if you take. So there will be some colors are 5, yes. One set, one color will be, I think, red. Yes, some other color will be black. Yes, so like this cards will be different. So these are the sample space. So this is just a highlighting and discussion about the probability. Is it clear, students? So next we are going to go for the number of all possible outcomes may be. So after doing this, all the experiments, outcomes and sample space, what are the outcome, possible outcomes? First one will be finite, obviously, which we can count. Any set, any outcome, any experiment, any sample space, we take it as finite. Okay, finite probability. So all the possible outcomes from throwing a single die, all possible 5 cards poker hands, we take it as the finite. So it's just finite. Already you come across what is finite. Next we have countable infinite. So what is this countable infinite? Number of proton to proton events to be made before a huge bonus event in observation, means when proton and proton event takes place. Suppose a simple, we can give an example, that is a bomb. Yes, it is a countable, but it is infinite. When it explodes, it energy just comes out from the bomb. So what it happens, it actually goes for collision, and it is infinite collisions, but we can countable because the particular area will be damaged, so it is countable. Simple. So next we have constitute a continuum. So this is heights of people. So what it says, when you continue heights of people, if you can calculate, so it will vary from one to another. So we say it is nothing but constitute a continuum or continuous. It is continuous. Heights of the people is stopped, yes, at certain age it is going to stop, but in the beginning we cannot say yes, Arun will be having 6 feet, yes, Abhishek will be having 2 feet, 5 feet, yes. So different people will have different height, and we cannot say that this is fixed. Height is not fixed, it is increasing. At some certain age it is will be fixed. So we say this type of event is nothing but our possible outcomes, we take generally it as constitute. So in case A, a sample space is said to be finite, that is clear. So in case A and B, the sample space is said to be discrete, just they have given different names. You have to just remember how it is finite, how it is discrete. And in case C, the sample space is said to be continuous. Very simple, continuous. Height of the people, they are changing, yes, we cannot fix the of them people. Next word you have to understand here is an event. What is an event, students? In any subset of sample space, sample set, including the empty set and the whole set. So what it means, so you have so many events, right? The festivals are there, that is an event. Yes, you come across a birthday, that is an event, right? The college event is now going to come, that is an, we say this is the event. So what are the event now? This is a part of the college. So you are going to have a function. Yes, it is coming now. So in this function, we say, take this one single function as the event. It is a part of the college curricular activity. So we say it is as a subset. Yes or no? It is also important. So we take as in the set, in the college, it is a part. When we take a part, we say it in mathematics, we say it as subset of a sample set. So event you have to understand. Suppose if there are two events that have no outcomes, means both are equal, like, so in common are called mutually exclusive event. So if you take any two events and if you continuously having at a time, so then the both cannot be compared. Suppose if you are having two events in the college, like when you are playing cricket, is event is going on, one chess is going on. So simultaneously you cannot go for both. Either you have to choose one and either you have to leave one. So such events we take it as the mutually exclusive events. So you have to just understand the word. What is mutually exclusive events? At a time both the events will go on. And what are the outcomes? Yes, in cricket there will be scores. Yes, there will be a, there will two event, two groups will be there and their outcomes are different. Whereas in chess, here the outcomes are different. Yes. So in cricket you can see so many participants will be there, but in chess, in one board there will be only two participants. So the such events are nothing but mutually exclusive event. So we'll continue this discussion. In discussing discrete sample space, it is useful to use Venn diagram. So already in the 10th you have studied about the Venn diagram, students. So it is no need of discussing Venn diagram much. And basic set theory. So already set theory is very important in the schools, and we have come across so many sets: finite set, infinite set, countable, uncountable. All this will come under set theory. So but here general we take it as discrete sample space in probability. Therefore we will refer to a union. Yes, suppose if you take any two events A and B, and we are running, we are continuing the event simultaneously, just we will take it as A union B. In mathematics we say A plus B. So how many events you are going to have, that many union you are going to have. So suppose there are 10 events, so what will be the total? It will be like A B C D E F G H I J. There will be 10 union. So A union B union C union, like this all together we consider this as 10 event. Similarly intersection, A intersection B, and then complement. Complement of any event we take it as A bar of events A and B. Suppose if it is B, then we take it as B bar, and suppose if we take A, we take it as A bar. So I'll just show you a dais. So this is a dais. I think everyone have come across this dais. So dais has 6 sides. Each side has a distinct number 1 to 6 dots. So every time when you rotate this, either it will be 1, 2, 3. So what are the possible outcomes, students? It is 6. The possible outcomes of dais is 6. So don't say that there is 7. See, it is just what you have to understand. So what I was saying in the beginning, some terminology is used in the card games. So what I was saying, sets of 5. Yes, if you remember. So what is this 5 I was discussing about? Yes, a flush. A flush is a hand of playing cards where all cards are of same suit. So if you just see, these are all having the, yes, what is this? A shape. I can tell you, this is the one shape where these all, yes, correct. So all these five are having same shape. So we take this as the first set of five. Similarly, if you go to the straight, so what is this set now? I will tell you, see, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. This is one set. Number is 5. So these are the possible outcomes. Here next, what we have here again, we have three of the kinds. So we can see 8, 8, 8 are 1, then red color are 2, black color are 3, so then we have 6 and 5. So these are the number of sets we get in the cards you have to come across. Yes. The next we'll go very simple definition of classical definition of probability. So there we have a very important definition. So we come across now formula. You have to remember this formula for your examples. We'll start now. If there are m outcomes in a sample space, if there are m outcomes in the sample space and all are equally likely of being the result of an experiment measurement, then the probability of observing an event that contains S outcomes is given by S divided by M. So very simple. Definition may be a little bit confusing. I will tell you very simple. So suppose there are, if you take a dais, number of outcomes, that is total number of outcomes, will become 6. That is M. Remember, M is nothing but outcomes in the sample space. So therefore, what are the outcomes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, so 6 are the outcome. Suppose if you throw one once, so what will be the outcome? What will be the probability? So you should say that 1 divided by 6. Is it clear? Suppose if you take a coin, yes, if you take a coin and toss the coin, yes, so can anybody tell me what is the outcome?
Or the 1 divided by 2.
Yes, that's it. So this is a simple. So it is 1 divided by 2. Very good. So simple examples I have taken. Probability of drawing an ace. Can you draw an ace? Means you are going to remove ace from the 52 cards. What will be the probability? Yes, very simple. A sample space consisting of 52 outcomes. Correct. Then desired events, that is ace, is the set of 4 outcomes. Number of desired outcomes is 4. Therefore, the probability of getting an ace is 4 divided by 52. Simple. So therefore, what is the probability? It is 1 divided by 13, or we say 4 divided by 12. It is enough. And very, very important, students, if possible, write down the axioms of probability. So this is a very important. Yes. So you have, for examples, you are going to use this axioms of probability. So this we starts, as we have discussed about the probability, outcomes, experiment, yes, we come across so many things, and then a very important, we are going to start here. So we have discussed already 15 to 20 minutes. Now we'll start our main concept about the examination, that is axioms of probability. So let S be a finite sample space, A an event in S. We define P of A. So P of A is clear now. It is probability of A to be the value of an additive set function P of A that satisfies the following three conditions. So very, very important, these three conditions you can see here. Yes. So if you look at this, these conditions are very, very important. So what are the axioms? Can anyone has the idea of axiom? What is axiom? Yes, no, then I will tell you. Axiom is a directly taken the statement, like it's raining. When we say it's raining, means water is going to fall from the sky and then from the cloud, and it is going to reach the earth surface, and it is fixed. You cannot change. Is there anyone who is going to change water from the earth will replace to the clouds? Is it happens? Water, especially, not steam. Only water. No, it is, we cannot do. Yes. And even the light, earth is not going to give the light to sun. Yes. Just an example. Sun is going to give light to the earth. So these are the axioms. Means it is fixed. Yes. A mechanical student can become only mechanical engineer. You cannot call that mechanical student, mechanical engineer as to do the, any work in electrical. So it is fixed that mechanical student is going to work as mechanical engineer. So like this, we have come across the axioms of probability. So the first axiom you can see, yes, it is the first axiom you can see. 0 is less than equal to P of A, which is less than equal to 1 for each event A in S. Means what I am saying, any probability you take, either it must be less than or equal to 0 probability, but it will not cross 1. Okay, that is what we have the probability. You have seen in the last example. Suppose if you take A's in a card, in a pack of cards, that is 52 cards, then the probability will become 1 upon 13, less than 1. So if you go for the tossing the coin, it is 1 upon 2. Again, it is less than 1. So this is what the first axiom says. 0 is less than equal to P of A, which is less than equal to 1 for each event A in S. So this is how you have to remember and try to understand. It's a simple, already you came across in the 10th standard. So probabilities are real numbers on the interval 0 and 1. So we say that these are the probability students. They are come across in the interval 0 and 1 only. Okay, so we'll go with the next one. What is the probability of S? Yes, the axiom 2 says that if you take the set itself, suppose if I take cards, they are 52. So what are the outcomes of 52 cards? Can anybody tell me? It is 52 divided by 52, it is 1. So if you take a coin, tossing a coin, so if you toss the coin, what will be the total outcomes divided by number of outcomes? So 2 divided by 2, it is 1. Sample space is 2. Divided by total number of outcomes is also 2. So 2 divided by 2 is always 1. So we say that the probability of some events occurring from S is unity. That is, P of S is 1. So remember, first axiom, 0 is less than P of A is less than equal to 1. And axiom 2 says P of S is equal to 1. Okay. So we'll go for axiom 3. If A and B are mutually exclusive events in S, yes, then P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. Yes, so these are the events what we get. Just 1 minute, students. Yes, sorry for the disturbance. So what we were discussing about, axiom 3, if A and B are mutually exclusive events in S, then P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. So it is very simple. If there are two events, what you are going to start, then what are the results you are going to get? That is, from event A plus event B. So that is the probability says. So when you come across the examples, this will be very easy. So what here you have to note, that these axioms do not tell us what the set function P of A is, only what property it must satisfy. So what this event axioms are telling is not so important, but these properties are very, very important. So here, very important, student, the classical definition of probability. So this first formula of probability, please, you can write down. So what it says, probability defines the function as P of A is equal to N of A divided by N of S. So for any number A is the sample space, yes, means number of events divided by number of sample space. So note that this definition satisfies all the three axioms. Yes, very, very important, students. Now till from half an hour, just define what is probability. It is P of A is equal to number of N of A divided by N of S, that is number of events divided by number of sample space. Remember at least this much for the examination point of view. Then we come across the elementary properties of probability function. Yes. So this is the very simple that if you take, already I have told you, yes. So if A1, A2, An are mutually exclusive events in a sample space, yes, then by induction on axiom 3, P of A1 union A2 union dot 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 union An. So these are all combining all the probabilities, P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3. So it is very simple. Then next we'll see elementary properties of probability function. This is in Venn diagram, I have already told you. So if A and B are any events in S, then P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B minus P of A intersection B. So means what? If you take this, if this is very simple using Venn diagram, if you see, so this is our A, okay, and that next circle will become B event. So when you combine this both the events, then what is the probability? This will become P of A plus P of B minus whatever the between, in between, whatever the intersection is there, that we have to minus this probability. So minus P of A intersection B, because if you consider full event, so it is already intersecting. Means suppose there are some students playing cricket and there are some students playing chess. Yeah, so it, if you take 10 plus 10, it will be 20. But actually what, this is not the probability. Actually, in 10 students, 4 students are playing cricket as well as chess. So it is not 10 plus 10, 20 students are there. Am I right? So how many students are there? 6 students from probability A and 6 students from probability B. So all together it is going to become how much? And in between, 4 students are there who are playing chess as well as cricket. So 4 will be there. So there will be 16 students only. So if you combine both the events, so you are going to get 16. That is, probability of A is 10 students, probability of B is 10 students, and minus both the events they are playing, therefore minus 4 events. So 20 minus 4 will become 16 students. So like this, this is also one of the properties of probability function. So next we will go with the conditional probabilities. Students, you can see a very simple conditional probability. What it says, the probability of an event is only meaningful if we know the sample space S under consideration. So we'll take just S, a sample space, very, very important. Then we'll go with the probability that you are the tallest person changes if we are discussing being the tallest person in your family or the tallest person in this class. So just little bit confusion, don't go about this understanding. What it says in conditional probability, so it depends on condition, that is what it's saying. Yes, don't get confused. So what is the conditional probability? It says, don't get confused or don't get what is the height of the tallest person. So it differs. Suppose you may tall in the class. Yes, you may not be tall in the outside. Suppose in mechanical A, one student has got first rank. Yes, probably congratulate for him or now only. So if he takes first rank in the mechanical B and its percentage is 85. Okay, probably it may go 90 also. So we'll take 85. But in mechanical B, suppose one student has taken first rank and his percentage is 85.5. So it doesn't mean that he is first. Yes, in his particular class, he is first. But if you compare A division and B division, he is second. So conditional probability says that depending on the situation, the condition will change. This is how you have to understand by conditional probability. So this is clarified using the notation P of A slash S, or P is divisible by S, or A slash S. So this means that the condition probability of event A related to the sample space, yes. So it is relating to the sample space. Depending on the situation, conditional probability is there. So we come across the very important formula in this for the exam. If A and B are any events in S and P of B is not equal to 0, the conditional probability of A relative to B is given like this. So P A divisible by B is equal to P of A intersection B divided by P of B. So depends on the Venn diagram. If you go through Venn diagram, this conditional probability we come across very easily, it is understood. So this is also fixed, student. So this formula we are going to use for the next example. So next, again, condition probability, what we have, if we find that P A divisible by B is equal to A, P of A. So this is P of A, means that then we state that event A is independent of event B. It completely depends on P of A. Means suppose two events are taking place, A and B. Already I have told you about the results. 85 in mechanical A division he has taken, and in mechanical B he has taken 85.5. So what will be the probability? 85.5 will be the highest. So it is independent. It depends on the result what you are going to get. So in the next year, next semester, it will vary. So this is what we have. So next, again, a simple theorem. What it says, P of A divisible by B and P of B divisible by A are related specifically. Means it depends. Suppose in one semester, in mechanical A, one student has got 86. In mechanical B, one student has highest marks, they have scored 85. So it is related. So one semester, one student will get, definitely will get one. And in another semester, definitely one student will be higher. So it depends. So we cannot say that this is fixed. Okay. So very, very important, student, that is mean for a probability distribution. So this is very important concept. It's different than the mean you will know before. So the mean, whatever you have studied before, is different. Here in probability distribution, we take the mean in different. So mean of a random variable with a discrete probability distribution is, so this is very simple formula they have given. So mean of a random variable, we take it as mu, and these are all the probabilities and these are all the events. So this is equal to sum of x into p of x. So where x means, here we are going to take x1, x2, x3, they are the outcomes, and we are going to multiply this with the respect to probabilities, that is P of x1, P of x2, P of xn, so on. So this all together, sum of all together, we are going to take it as mean of a random variable. So in the next class, or the in continuing with this class, we take x is equal to xi and mu is equal to E of xi. So xi's are nothing but our outcomes, and pi's are nothing but our, we are going to take here as probabilities, and this all together we just take it as mu, or we consider this as E of xi, means they are the sum of all the events what we are going to just denote it a different letter. So remember this, students, very, very important. Next, remember this formula, mean is equal to E of x, that is events of x, is equal to sum of x into p of x. So I'm going to ask this formula again in the next, in the upcoming example. So mean is equal to E of x is equal to sum of x into p of x. So very simple formula they have given. So what does this mean actually? We'll just go fast. Mean of the random variable. So already you have done the random variable. So I have taken 3 now. In the first, I got TTT. I tossed the 3 coins simultaneously. I got TTT. Second, I have got HTT, THT, and TTH. In the third event, I have got HHT, HTH, THH. And the third, I have got HHH. So means T is nothing but tail and H is nothing but head. So at a time, I have tossed 3 coins. I may get TTT, and these are all these things we get. So I'll just tell you what is the mean. So mean says that sum of all the exclusive outcomes, so this is 0, this is one, this is two, and this is third outcomes what we have got here, students. Is it clear? So what are the probabilities we get? They are different. Here only one event is there, therefore I have taken 1/8. In the second outcome, you can see I have got three different outcomes. So this is 3/8. In the second time, again it is three outcomes, therefore 3/8. And in the third event, I have got this as only one outcome. Therefore, what will be the mean? Sum of all into their outcomes. So means sum of xi into p of xi. So what is xi now? 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, this many outcomes is conducted. So every outcome we have event. So how many here we have? P1 is nothing but 1/8. P2 is nothing but 3/8. P3 is nothing but 3/8 again. Yes. And then P4 is nothing but 1/8. If you just simplify this, runs, we are going to get mean, that is mu is equal to 12/8, which is equal to 3/2, which is equal to 1/2. So this is a mean. So this is how we have to say, just simplify this mean of the variance. Similarly, we'll go with the variance of a random variable. So mean of a random variable you come across. So since we use the mean as the measure of center for a discrete random variable, we'll use the standard deviation as our measure of spread. So even mean will be for only one random variable. Variance will be more than one random variables now. Suppose in the last we have seen coin we have taken. Yes, that was a simple event and coin was the one, only one event. So we take it as the mean of a random variable. So when you take two at a time, suppose a coin is tossed and something else like dice is, yes, rolled down, or if you are collecting the cards in the 52 cards, if you take any A's, so they are different. So if you compare any two events which are totally different, so we take it as the more than one event, we take variance. Just understand this meaning, more than one event, we take it as variance. So here also you can see variance of a discrete random variable. Suppose that X is a discrete random variable whose probability distribution is. So these are the distribution they have given directly, and mu X is the mean of X. Already we have solved it. The variance of X is found by multiplying each squared deviation of X by its probability and then adding all the products. So altogether, just I will denote this variance, that is VAR X is equal to, this is sigma X square, that is variance, it is denoted by variance. And then you are going to subtract this every outcomes with the different various variance and then square them, and we are going to have P1, P2, P3 as the probabilities. So all together this is going to give the variance, that is sum of xi minus mu x raised to square and then pi. So remember this variance, simple it is. Mu is nothing but mean, xi's are nothing but outcomes, p's are nothing but the probabilities. This is what the variance it has given directly. So here we'll just see one simple example, students. So what it says for the variance of random variable. So we'll just see by using the example. So consider again same points, same I have taken outcome, same events you have done. So how mean is calculated you have came across? It is 3/2. But variance will change. Variance we are going to get this as sigma square x is equal to x1 minus mu raised to square, yes, p1 plus x2 minus mu the whole square p2 and so on. So when you simplify x1, it is 0, x2 is 1, x3 is 2, x4 is 3. So you have to substitute the mean. Mean will remain same, student. So 3/2, 3/2, 3/2, here also 3/2. What is the probability of 1, first one? It is 1/8. So because you can see here, it is only one outcome, TTT. So 1 divided by it. So multiply 1 divided by it. Similarly, what will be the second one? It is 3 divided by it. Next one, 3 divided by it. Next one, we are going to go for 1 divided by 8. So if you just simplify this and sum all this, that is our variance, which is 3 divided by 4. So what we get here? 3 divided by 4 is equal to 0.75. Okay. So this is how we have to find the variance of a random variable. So this is for just for your theorem. I have just given one very simple example. You can just go through. So this is not so important, but just you should go through this example. Okay. So this is all discussion about the probability. And remember, what to remember? First one, mean. Remember this formula, summation x, p of x, variance, e of x square minus e of x the whole square. That is what variance formula I have told you already. This is, in this, e of x square is equal to sum of x square into p of x. So already you know, e is nothing but event, x is nothing but the outcomes, p of x is nothing but probability of x. So these are the rules. You can go through later. So not much to discuss here. Yes. So very
so
important.
What happens from this figure there for example?
This one. This examples will come. So this is very important example. So you can write down. A random variable x has the following probability function for various values of x. So you can just see this question. X they have given, p of x they have given in the exam also. There is no confusion now. This is the probability is going to come for the exam, and these are the examples you are going to. It is going to appear in the exams.
So
this
please
is a very simple.
Question.
Yes, please.
So please show the question.
Yes, random variable x has the following probability function for various values of x. So x they have given, for every x they have given probabilities. And they have told you to find k, and then they have also told you to find, evaluate p of x is less than 6, p of x is greater than equal to 6, and p of 3 is less than equal to x less than equal to 6. I will share this notes, don't worry. Evening I will share the video and question and answers. So this is what they have told, means you have first you have to find k, then probability of x is less than 6 means. Less than 6 means how many outcomes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This, so 0, 1, 2, 3 till 5 outcomes we are going to take and find the probability. So just they have changed the condition. See, x is greater than or equal to 6. Means which is greater than or equal to 6 and 7 are the outcomes. Then you are going to find the probability of only 6 and 7. And then they have told you to find probability of between 3 and 6. So between 3 and 6 is 3, 4, 5 and 6, 4. 4 outcomes we have seen. Okay, this is how we have to understand the question. I'll just simplify this. So what we get here? So this is what we get the, okay. Simple example this is. So these are the solutions what we get. Very simple solutions we get here. So x you know, and then you know p of x, yes. So already you know students that all the outcomes, if you take all the outcomes, if you add them, this is always equal to 1. Yes or no? For last, this one I have already told you the formula. Sum of all p of x, that is probability of all, will be 1 only. Suppose if you take the cards 52 upon 52, it is 1. If you take coins, how many total outcomes? 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Therefore, these are again outcomes, I have added them, this is equal to 1. We just simplify them, we are going to get 10k square plus 9k minus 1 is equal to 0. So k is equal to, we take here as 1 upon 10. If you can calculate and substitute the values, it is simple. I will tell you in the some other class. So you can just simplify and remember k is equal to 1 upon 10 we get. If you simplify here, 1 upon 10, so you can just simplify this, you are going to get this is equal to 0. Or in the calculator, if you calculate, if you take the positive value, you can take this k is equal to 1 upon 10. I will show you, or I will put it in your classroom. So there is no issue. So when you simplify this, students, In the first one, we have calculated k is equal to 1 upon 10. So you can just see the what is the probability. Now substitute. In the question, they have given c. So 0 will be 0 only first. And then for the x event 1, it is 1 divided by k. So they have already given it as k. So here k is 1 upon 10. So I'll substitute 1 upon 10. 2, they have given 2k. So 2 into 1 upon 10. So it is 2 divided by 10. Very simple. In the third one, they have given 2k again. So 2 into 1 divided by 10. Just I have simplified this. So then already I have told you students that p of x is less than 6. Less than 6 means how many events are there? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So all events I have taken till 5. Add this 0, 1 upon 10, 2 upon 10, 2 upon 10, 3 upon 10, 1 upon 10. If you add, you will get probability, that is 0.81. Is it clear, student? Similarly, if you go for the probability of x greater than or equal to 6. So it is only 2, 6 and 7. Add this 2 upon 100, 17 upon 100. It is 0.19. So next one they have told you to calculate. P of 3, between 3 and 6. So between 3 and 6 is 3, probability of 3, probability of 4, probability of 5 and probability of 6. Add them. What are the probabilities we get? It is 2 divided by 10, 3 divided by 10, 1 divided by 100 and 2 divided by 100. Add them. So you get 0.53, students. So this is very simple. So if any doubt is there, you can go through the videos once again. So just addition they have given. Complicated formulas, definitions they have given. Don't go with the definitions and all. So can you try this, students, by using that method? So I think this is very simple now. A random variable x has the following probability function. So x is given, p of x is given, and this I will share in the class. So you can try this, students. Yes, so we'll complete this class. So thank
you. Sir, explain this answer.
Explain this once again. Okay, so what
sir,
we
this
have
problem is, sir, only this problem.
Okay, this problem, fine. At least you would have tried this. Find k and find mean and variance. So I'll just show you how we have to calculate the k. So k, I already have told you, sum of p of x is equal to 1. So add this all the events, calculate the value, we are going to get k is equal to 0.1. And the variance. Variance is what we have already given the formula. Sum of x into p of x. So x is nothing but the total out, what we have got the outcome. So first one it was minus 2, minus 1, and then 0 and 1 outcomes you have got. What are the probabilities? Probability is same. 0.1 is same. So 0.1 into 0.1, 0.1, everywhere. Here we have got 0.2 because there is outcomes, it depends on outcome. So when you multiply and add this, so we are going to get the mean e of x is equal to 0.8. So this is what we get, e of x. So in the same process, so in the last I have told you how to find the variance. So variance is given, so same formula I told to remember. Variance is e of x square minus e of x the whole square. So it means nothing but e of x square, you know already, sum of x square into p of x. So sum of x square p of x is nothing but square this. So previously we have calculated for e of x square only x values. So x1 is squared, x2 is square, x3 is square, yes, x4 is square, x5 is square, x6 is square, and then multiply the probabilities. It is 0.1, 0.1, 0.2, 0.2, 0.3, 0.1. multiply. Just simple calculation is very less here, understanding is more, calculation is very less. So if you put, you are going to get 2.8. so e of x square we get 2.8, and e of x you know already, students, it is 0.8. so variance is equal to e of x square minus e of x the whole square. So e of x the whole square, you can just substitute 2.8, and then minus e of x the whole square is 0.8 square. So if you just calculate, it is equal to 2.16, students. Is it clear? So very simple. Go through the video. If you have any doubt, I will continuing this in the next class. Whatever if Sunday is available or any other classes are available, when you are free, I will try to finish this example. Some more examples you can try. Yes. So thank you.